In his book, he was traveling in Africa and he came across a cannibal tribe. These cannibals, they eat humans. He was astonished that one of the tribe's men had been educated in America. He said, after American English education, you still eat human flesh? Then what is the difference? That cannibal said, the difference is earlier I used to eat it with my fingers, now I eat it with knife and fork. That's not much of a difference, is it? What does it count for? It's so easy for our mind to make excuses. You know, I could not do it because the bird went over the head. There's an inspiring story about awareness from the Japanese tradition. There has been a great sword fencer called Mataijuro Yagyu. His father was also a great sword fencer. But his father trained the other sons and he gave up on this guy that you are no good. So nevertheless, Mataijuro Yagyu went to another, the greatest swordsman of the land. And he said, will you teach me this? That master said, I will, but you will do exactly as I say. And you will not use your intellect. Mataijuro Yagyu said, all right, start cleaning the vessels of the monastery. Mataijuro Yagyu started cleaning the vessels, then he had to cook, and then he had to clean the room and get the water from the river. And this went on and on and on. 1 year went by, 2nd year went by. He started getting disappointed. There is no talking as well of the sword fencing. I had come to learn it, and there is no question about it. I only clean vessels and take care of the house. A 3rd year went by. Finally, that master, he came from behind one day. Mataijuro Yagyu was cleaning a vessel. He whacked. He said, be careful, henceforth I can come and hit you at any time. I said, all right. Now he started developing his awareness, and this master would come and whack him at any time. Slowly, slowly, he started getting more and more alert until he would be able to gauge and judge and dodge. Until his awareness developed even more, when the merest whiff and he would turn around and probably catch the stick or something. So the master said, now you are ready. Now I will teach you sword fencing. So it's a question of being completely aware. Don't make excuses. He's pretty strict. He says, irrespective of time, place, circumstance, make it like a universal vow. Make it a commitment. When you are interested in something, you do it when you like. When you are committed to something, you do it whether you like or you don't like. That's the kind of commitment he is demanding. Don't make compromises. This will require tremendous awareness. You know, the opposite of awareness is carelessness. The devotees have their own way of being aware. Be aware of the presence of God. Maharaji says, be aware that God and Guru are with you and watching you all the time. So this kind of carefulness requires a great motivation and a great dedication. You need to have complete lack of carelessness and complete application to the task. This will come when you have a strong why, a strong reason motivating you. And the biggest reason motivating us is that the human form is a golden chance for the salvation of the soul. If we don't utilize it, we will go back. Haji Sahab, you are a human being in this life, what are you going to become in your next life? Ji, I'm going to become a dhobi ka gadha. My God, after the human being, you're becoming a dhobi ka gadha, you've gone back down. Yes, I did not utilize the chance I had. So the opportunity is tremendous, but the time span is limited. And that time